Guys, I just only realised that the frickin' BBC are videoing this. I'm quite nervous actually. It's going to be on TV at the 10:30 slot this evening, which is scary. But there we go. Good morning, guys. Welcome to another daily vlog. So it's now the 8th February and it's 10:04. I'm just going to go down to the Galve, quickly visit everyone there, and then head down to my educational support lecture. So yeah, that's going to be fun. I shall catch you guys in a bit. Guys, I'm departing the Galve. Now straight out, the walk's coming in. I'm gonna depart. See you all later. At Deep End, and now it's 4:55, and I'm just waiting to set up for the comedy night at 7. But yeah, katsu curry. Guys, we're getting ready for the event. Got the lights working and everything. Yeah. Guys, I just only realised that the frickin' BBC are videoing this. I'm quite nervous actually. It's going to be on TV at the 10:30 slot this evening, which is scary. But there we go.
Anna said, "I'm really sorry, mate. Do you just have anything without meat?" And he looks at the menu, looks at me, and went, "We've got duck."
Okay,
I said, "Well, duck is, it's still meat, isn't it, right? It's one of the most beautiful things I've ever heard of. Well, it swims, it's part fish." It's kind of logic there. But the show that I sort of did, so this is a show, the show is quite nice to do, and it is something that I'm really passionate about, because some eating disorders are a big deal. Eating disorders have affected people like Kelly Clarkson, Lily Allen, Victoria Beckham. It's a huge problem. You know, it's responsible for a lot of music, right? And I wanted to use comedy in order to talk about it, because I think one of the things that was most difficult for me when I was going through anorexia is people started talking to me differently, like I was something fragile, like I was going to break at any point. But I started quite openly sort of relapsing when I did that show. And there was a number of reasons why I started relapsing. Firstly, it's that thing that I spoke about earlier on. I didn't feel ill enough to talk about it. But also, I don't think I was strong enough to either. And a lot of the things that people said to me really started getting to me. Like, a lot of people said to me, "You don't look anorexic." And I now know that the correct response to something like that is, "Well, you don't look like a idiot." But here we are, we're both surprised, aren't we? Also, one of the things that really got to me as well is I was in a sort of bar and I was talking to a woman. Forget that live in the apartment. A couple of things I've got to do. If you've enjoyed this event, please follow Molly Fandershot on Twitter. Please follow them. Yeah, let's give a massive round of applause there. Like this, because this is also in conjunction with Wimmer and also Beats
bit
as well. Beats,
I love
charity. I love Beats for another reason. I was getting ready for this gig last week and I got a call from my contact Tony. and I just had to, I was really late for the train, and I was wearing my hand to email them to remind me, I wrote back my hand, beat, totally.
Right.
Just came across as that really lazy domestic abuse, right? But I was really, really late for a train, and like the guys were looking at me, and I just, like, the guy I sat next to, I went, don't worry, he deserves it. Like that, and very awkward. So if you have enjoyed that, please keep supporting events like this. It's a wonderful cause. If you have enjoyed that, please follow me on Twitter, @DaveTrauner.